Well, you know, Contractz has to be, you have to be comfortable on something if you're going to be giving tips to other people in that sense. I don't think the Kane will come out this game, but we might be surprised. LeBlanc, Zach, obviously going to start things off. Should see the Elise out there. And Thresh, as he's been finding himself on that ban list a lot more in recent patches.
Piglet in a very happy mood, talking about ban that Thresh out, no problem. Get me Kalista first pick, please. Caitlyn actually still on the table here. I think Cloud9 will probably use their last ban if Team Liquid don't jump on it here. So probably be the Caitlyn ban, and Team Liquid might actually be able to get that Kalista for Piglet, and he can continue smiling.
Syndra from Jensen. That's a pretty easy one to get off the list. I think that power pick away from him or just about anybody. And 20 seconds left here for Cloud9. What do they really prioritize taking away last? What would they give Team Liquid, really?
To Caitlyn or not to Caitlyn?
Yep.
I think that they will ban the Caitlyn. They could switch it up here. They could leave both Caitlyn and Kalista up. Problem is, Caitlyn's range then is difficult for Kalista to deal with early on, so you don't really want to trade those two champions because they're both marksmen. They have to match up in the lane, and Caitlyn has a tremendous range advantage that is very annoying, so not going to be the case. Will they pull the trigger? So it's actually the Maokai first. Both of them left up, and they're going to give away the Kalista, it looks like. Lourlo or ReignOver will be in command of this champion. Works great from the jungle, great from the top lane. Both of them have actually used it before as well.
And how did Cloud9 answer? They know they're, if it goes too late, they're going to have to be able to destroy the tree somehow, some way. They get maybe a hyper carry on their team, putting Tristana in there. More of a demolitionist now, but can put that damage down towards the late game here. They're looking for some damage on C9.
It's pretty rare. It has happened before, but a couple other teams have prioritized Tristana over Kalista, but it is so rare because so many teams just really value the mid-game spike of Kalista as well as the dragon control that makes it really easy for her to slide over and execute those. Tristana, picking that one early, she does have the explosive shot trades that we always like to mention and are beneficial into the Kalista, but a lot of other people still going for that one. Anyways, GoldenGlue, Bot Boy, able to get one of his favorite champions. He has actually a pretty long history with Taliyah. I talked to him when he took his little, soul-searching trip over to Korea.
Soul-searching? I like that.
After he got benched there for, one of the times.
Right.
and he went over to Korea to improve and play in solo queue. And one of the things he came back with and he was talking a lot about to me were all the little things he learned about Taliyah. And how to use, the move speed from her works ground and how to go for trades in specific matchups. So I'm always, pretty happy to see him get this champion because he felt like he improved a lot on it while he was over there.
I've been waiting to see this guy come back a few times here and there, but Trundle back in the mix with so many BP tanks back in the lineups.
Trundle, everybody's first thought as soon as the tank meta approaches is, where's Trundle at? When's he going to shred all these tanks? The ultimate is perfectly suited for taking down those defenses of the front line and boosting his own. Mm-hmm. He can also split push, which people always just mention the ultimate and kind of leave it at that. But not only does he individually, have aspects and have parts of the kit that are very good versus tank meta, but he also, as far as working in a team strategy, can deal with it quite well because if you can split push and pull the other team apart and tanks are notorious for mid game, they pretty much have to be 5-on-5-ing, and that's where the biggest strength comes from. Trundle does have more options than that.
I like the interactions. I'm thinking about, you get a Maokai ultimate, you throw a pillar up, a lot of disengage there. But also a lot of catch potential here from TL. They can fly forward with this composition so far and crowd control someone. Kalista, and we get the Morgana coming off from the Cloud9 side. Few more mid laners hit here. LeBlanc, Syndra, Cassiopeia. What's our final ban from Liquid?
Maybe Orianna. People are like okay with that matchup, but that might be the last mid lane champion that they would ban. They're actually, still gonna just leave that one up. Taliyah does quite well into the matchup and can roam better than Orianna. Nobody really like beats Orianna or like dumpsters her, but Taliyah can do different things, right? You can shove her a bit early and try and get the roam game off.
Blitzcrank gets taken out, preventing Smoothie from his third player of the summer split on that champion. Will he take the Alistar?
I talked about it actually in the series that we had before this. I was thinking that Aframu was going to be playing Alistar, but Alistar got some buffs, you know, 5% extra damage reduction on his ultimate in the last patch, and that combined with the previous trample buff that we had a couple patches ago.
Crowd control plus his other
hits. I really do think you know, Alistar here should be moving up the tier list for supports, and Smoothie's going to be able to take that one.
Scaling. A little late game here, put onto the Kog'Maw. Piglet's going to be looking to rain down the living artilleries. See if he can hit true targets. What will they combo this with, though? What will Matt take?
Still have quite a few options here as far as playmaking as well. But whenever you have the Kog'Maw, it always helps to have a little bit of added defenses. You can either go kind of LPL theory and have just your front line charge forward and everybody super aggressive and have Kog'Maw, you know, pulling up the rear, or you can have a little bit more defense here. They've got versatility. There's a Gragas for disengage. Now they have Janna for disengage as well, which kind of opens up the Gragas to be able to use, you know, his cast more offensively sometimes. Interesting for Jensen hovers, but he actually locks it in. All right, Cloud9 are going to be running the Twisted Fate into Taliyah. Talk about roaming. He definitely one of the very best. Let me check here. Actually, this will be Jensen's first Twisted Fate of the summer for sure.
Yes, one more unique for him.
I'm gonna check all the way back of this actually entire year, maybe.
Check spring. Do it. A few new ones in here as well for Matt. He's actually gonna put himself, I believe, near the top of the list for most unique picks for supports. Putting himself for 12 or 13 with this one. Picks in the Janna for the first time for protection on Piglet. So Jensen and Matt kind of stretching their wings, if you will, opening up that champion pool just a little bit. We're about to head into game. Team Liquid versus Cloud9 as they get onto the Rift. Cloud9 looking to push the limit here in these last few games, just two behind a lot of the top on that tier, on the record list right now of where we place towards playoffs. Team Liquid, every win counts for them. The early game has been under control, but they cannot find the late game under fire. We'll see if they can do it here. Hashtag TL win, hashtag C9 win, as we get on to the Rift.
All right, let's take a look. Jensen, first Twisted Fate of the year. See if he can actually get off, you know, one of those bottom lane plays. That's where we often see him try and take advantage. The Kog'Maw is the obvious target, right? Even with the Janna early on, she won't be level 6 before Twisted Fate is level 6, so you can make those plays on the bottom side. Alistar engage, Tristana jumps in with Rocket Jump, and Twisted Fate is there with a gold card. He's even bringing Ignite to the party. This is going to be an interesting little maneuver here. Have to keep your eyes wide open for the early game, especially with Contractz on Jarvan. There's a lot of possibilities for variable gank paths.
We see that Boots focus in the beginning. A lot of times, as you're saying, the Ignite, we see just the Flash Ghost, so TF can stay mobile, stay out of range of something, continue slinging gold cards. I like the aggression.
Yeah, and you know, Ghost is just so much more versatile for late game split pushing, you know, being able to move around those team fights, as you said, but Ignite brings that snowball potential. All right, everybody just, bad luck to interrupt an Alistar while he's hanging on the bell, by the way.
I like that. I've got to get behind that. See, Smoothie and Matt both actually going coin here. Sometimes you see Alistar and Pass go for that face of the mountain.
Just so much money. Got to get it. Yeah, the heals are pretty nice from face of the mountain and possible shields. But
money.
You can't really argue with money.
Nope.
Impact gets the first bite here on the bark, and he also is going to get a little bit of vision.
I like that. That's good. That's good.
Saplings here are going to help ReignOver with this pull, and it looks like Impact going to stick around until he sees the start. He wants to force him off this. Does actually lure away one sapling, but there's another one for ReignOver. Impact wants to make him use his smite. Not going to happen. Ooh, he actually does in the end as well.
A little afraid there. He might have gotten maybe a pillar kill. No, I'm just kidding.
The one true damage. It's technically a possibility.
Well, he didn't have two, but you're right. Yeah. It is. Piglet on the bot side. Trying to push against the percentage here. 82 to 19. Or 18, I should say, if I even read it right. As they continue to push up. And Matt looking to get those auto attacks in here. And just get a little brush control. But he's got to be careful for that all in real quick of C9.
Yeah. presence in lane towards into here, but you have to worry because there's another Ignite on Cloud9. Smoothie on Alistar also running it. So there are definitely no, you know, questions about what Cloud9 want to do early. It's bottom lane pressure. They've got lots of extra damage there. And maybe we'll see Contractz actually gank mid and then pass down to bottom. Jarvan is definitely one of the champions that does not want to just power farm early in the jungle. You know, they reduced a lot of the armor that he starts with, all the base armor. So usually we'll see him do three camps, maybe get some health off a Scuttlecrab or go for a gank early on. He goes for the look, hangs around in the river, but, you know, GoldenGlue is playing pretty defensively there in the mid lane, hovers to the bottom side, so no opportunity, and he's going to have to get back into the jungle and just clear out some of his red quadrant instead.
Very interesting the way you can kind of look at those ganks against the Taliyah as well. Has she kind of worked ground up to the left? So it would be more plausible that she'd actually take a fight with Jensen towards the bottom side if they were to gank that way. Kind of fun to play around those little things. Watch where GoldenGlue plays, and then attack when possible. Here it looks like they're cleaning up. It will reset in the mid, 23, just about 21 on that CS side. So even there, not too much discrepancy in the bottom, but Impact has been able to get a good push on the lane. Should be cleaned up by Lourlo, but he's able to continue warding on that bot side and keep small looks at where ReignOver might be. A little love from Contractz as well, if they thought Impact pushed up a little too much for that counter gank, but it looks like ReignOver will be headed that way, just a little late for some camps on Wolves and the top side.
Got his red buff ready, and one of the things about Maokai top lane is still has super good gank setup, and it's a very large possibility. Good ward though. Was that Contractz who put that before he recalled?
Impact just had it pushed and had the chance. He's been controlling the lane.
Well, ReignOver gonna use some time. In fact, saw him on that ward.
Ruh-roh. Few hits, about 210 HP. Bramble smash, not enough. And just calculated, like you said, Impact gets out. Should be able to walk this one back to lane if they don't double push it.
So let's talk about that a little bit, because whenever someone, you know, a jungler is waiting either on a blast cone like that or in a brush around your lane, so often, you know, in your solo queue or something, your laner will like throw a skill shot at them and be like, go away. But Impact wastes his time. He stays up front knowing that he's going to recall and use his teleport back anyway. He has time that there's an extra wave that Team Liquid would have to push. So he baits ReignOver, wastes a good chunk of ReignOver's time, which is very important as ReignOver, one of his biggest strengths has always been efficient pathing early on and controlling the extra camps of his enemies. So I really like that play from Impact, even though it's not a flashy play and it does not show up at all in statistics. It's the intelligent play there from the top laner, and this is the benefit, right? Contractz goes for a counter jungle, steals away all the small raptors, which is a large portion, you know, of the reward for that camp.
And now matching back up top lane, 42 to 28. But both even say, hey, call here, armor here. We're just going to keep farming out. Impact's more than happy to do that and get bigger on this Trundle.
Yeah, Impact can already bully, you know, in this Trundle Maokai matchup. Lourlo actually even missing some CS there, just sitting on the ground. And he knows that he doesn't even need more kill pressure. You just go call, continue to win the lane, and maybe he'll have a payout later.
A little love for Matt. Just got him on the bell. Smoothie's going to be able to add a bit of extra damage, but good focus from Piglet and Matt to just focus on Sneaky there in the return. They hold that off for now, but it looks like C9 does want a little bit of blood in that bot side. Here's Impact's aggression as he's getting these minions hurt as they get up to the wave. These are all going to be knocked out by the turret here, so Lourlo missing quite a bit of CS. Might get one of these guys.
And he's got to worry about a dive at the moment. Contractz heading up. There's an ultimate from Impact available. Ooh. Only one minion left, though. That's too late. And they're not going to have time to pull it off now, because even though you have Twisted Fate on your team, GoldenGlue on Taliyah can also, you know, wall up from the mid lane. And that dive going backwards would be a huge detriment to Cloud9. They're already, you know, in a very good spot this game, and they don't want to, you know, risk a tower dive at that stage, because there's a lot that they could throw away here.
It's nicely done. Sometimes teams feel like they've made a move on a position, so they have to continue to do so. Here, pulling off gives them another opening, and that's a lot of damage to start on a Contractz, but it's a 3v2 situation without GoldenGlue really be able to offer much from that range. Here's Lourlo now, but has he come too late? Looks like teleport to bot lane. Oh, just to fight in the bot lane. I apologize. Impax is still down, and looks like Matt will live out of this situation.
Nice little flash there from Contractz, dodging that ultimate. They're able to secure the kill. And the reason that Lourlo so late to the fight is because, again, Impact pressuring this matchup.
Yep.
Trundle gets to come first. You know, good job by Cloud9 pressuring on the area where they have strength.
See,
Twisted Fate ultimate comes down, so ReignOver has no way out. I guess he could have body slammed backwards over this wall, maybe, but C9 already had three members there. They're able to collapse. They grab the first blood, and they're able to, you know, not only get that kill, but I believe also steal away the blue.
Nice blue or pink ward placed by blue. TL getting themselves deep to get that vision ward in just on the side of Contractz. This may slow down his roll. Maybe they can start to make their own moves based on what his direction starts to be. ReignOver with a bit more info. Maybe they'll steal this over now for GoldenGlue.
Yeah, at least ReignOver gets kind of answer here.
Step back.
And they go for the counter blue. Able to trade them after the facts. GoldenGlue will be happy about that one. They, as of now, have not yet seen this control ward. GoldenGlue should be able to find it, though.
Yeah. No.
It's going to leave it for ReignOver to pick up.
Smart move.
Not going to dirty my hands with that control ward.
You wipe it off. I'll take the last one.
All right. Well, Jensen's first ultimate was successful. Nice invade for them. And it does allow him to try and, you know, get to this earlier Rod of Ages. A lot of times we'll see this. Oh, never mind. Okay, not going to go for that. A lot of times we will see the Rod of Ages start for the Twisted Fate when he's just kind of like farming this lane. He's not getting early cooldown reduction for his ultimates. He's not going for the super quick Lich Bane either, but you get a lot of defensive and you get a lot of sustain due to the Catalyst passive. So playing a little bit for, you know, the stacking up of the Rod, a little bit for that scaling.
Oh, cone in, body out. Doesn't look like he wants it to go that way. The team has four members now as Impact has Lourlo's number. Impact teleport also up. They probably have the timing on that one as he has Lourlo pushed into the turret. So, first dragon picked over by, or picked up by Cloud9 and goes over to them.
Pretty effortless objective here for Cloud9. Impact. Very big presence early on as well on this Jarvan. He was the one to get that kill, one to get that first blood. The one to pop the blast cone too.
Back over. Looks like GoldenGlue might try to roam down, but Jensen's just on his heels. Maybe they turn this one back around. A quick cue from GoldenGlue. Tongue twister. So much control up top.
Contractz again. He's back at it, and Sneaky's there with him. Oh, a little bit too early on that Cataclysm. ReignOver already sliding out over the wall, and he gets a 2-for-1.
Just in and out. No Sunfire for Impact. He wants to be able to make these dives possible for himself and continue to harass Lourlo. The Tiamat is his build. He looks to finish this call in 32 more CS. That's going at a pretty fast clip. He still has a lead in the lane. Smoothie looking for a little pressure here.
Goes
finds it.
Double.
And they stop Sneaky's damage with a quick Howling Gale.
A lot of pressure here from Cloud9, though, keeping them at the turret so that they can't answer roams. You know, a lot of Cloud9 has been top lane from Impact, having pushing, having pressure, allowing Contractz to have this early pressure. Then bottom lane as well. Smoothie and Sneaky constantly going aggressive, constantly pushing through the turret. So that's why it feels so much like ReignOver's playing catch-up. And Contractz is constantly the first one to these plays. For Team Liquid, they are doing an okay job at keeping up some defensive vision, but look at the gold. It's really taking its toll here as Cloud9 have been able to earn this, you know, 1,300 gold lead, mainly from their pushing lanes and that translating into jungle control.
And you see mid is even on CS, but TF still getting a bit of extra gold. Gonna have his item spikes a little bit quicker if nothing else plays into that lane. A lot of things, like you said, playing in favor of C9, it just kind of go at this pace, but we will have to see. Team Liquid looking at first turret percentage is 71% to Cloud9's 53, which is pretty odd, but that's a quick swing in the money that could equalize this game, open up the map, if TL can kind of push that pressure we saw from them recently in the early game. It's like they get pressured more so by C9 to start things off again towards the top side. GoldenGlue could get the flag and drag here towards the top. The team is coming. Here comes Team Liquid. Lourlo's going down fast. The turret aggro perfectly back and forth on the teammates. And now does Impact have the help? Jensen's going to have to be the bodyguard here. They can't get the seismic shove on.
Reignover's on the way.
And this is going to be tough. A gold card onto GoldenGlue could be bad. Reignover has the full spell reel. Looking to do damage onto Contractz. The rest of the team goes out. Contractz to flash out. Explosive cast. One last shot. C9 limping away, somehow still alive. Jensen wants to even fight some more as the bot lane holding on to everything here as top side could go to hell.
Impact does have teleport though, so Cloud9 make the escape after their kill. And even though Team Liquid get to put a bit of damage into this turret,
yeah,
Impact should be able to teleport right back out there and put a stop to it.
Pressure.
Oh, the answer teleport. He can't do anything about the 3v1, though. Low turret and Team Liquid might be able to answer with some first turret bonus.
There it is. Put that percentage up, Kobe. Team Liquid, they do open up that first turret, first blood gold, or first turret gold, I should say. And that still a little bit of a lead for C9 because they've been continuously making moves like this.
Here's another look at that tower dive. Impact, he not only gets the big heal for the kill there, but he also had the extra defenses still on from his ultimate, so he tanked up the turret very well. Here, GoldenGlue has a very quick cleanse to break that gold card, and he dodges a lot of the damage, hitting his threaded volleys and then flashing a knockup, but still, Reignover gets in there, knocks Impact over. They're not able to find any of the kills. With the health lead, though, as you know, the end of the story is that they still, with the map pressure, get the first turret bonus gold.
A lot of vision for C9, just above Jensen. Contractz has given him a very big human shield just in general and jungler proximity. As again, they go after GoldenGlue. Flash down, cleanse down, let's hit him.
Definitely, he is a big target. In the top lane skirmish as well, pretty much all those guys use their flashes, so Lourlo could still be a target here because Impact is absolutely smashing this top lane. Trundle loves these tank matchups. Mid lane, though, is the correct choice.
Oh, when summoners are down, so is GoldenGlue. C9 had that on the plate many minutes before they even got there. It's pretty much when they got back out to lane. We saw Smoothie headed towards mid. So now mid turret going, top turret going down with mid pressure from C9.
Top turret going down, mid laner going down.
Yeah.
Smoothie with a very good roam there on Alistar. Didn't even have to use his flash to create this play. And they actually got vision of him from Reignover. But even though they had vision of Smoothie, no vision of Contractz. And he was able to slide in there with the Jarvan. Slides over, gets the kill on the GoldenGlue. No summoners, as you said. Easy target.
Apparently Smoothie just a little late on a healer hit there. No assist. It's all right.
But he was the distraction.
He was the distraction.
They were like, oh, overall, look, Smoothie, he's so far away. He's not going to gank you, GoldenGlue. You're fine.
He's just sitting on those wards.
GoldenGlue, why'd you lie to me?
It's a long con. They didn't have that top side warded. And Jensen now 0-0-3. He's charging up. So kills are great, but the assists are good too as he looks for that Rod of Ages to get stacked. And he is safe in mid. 2k gold lead bumping up to 3k here as C9 starts to own another dragon in the game.
Oh, they own it all right. Maybe there'll be a Kog'Maw steal from Piglet. That's the only thing I can possibly see here.
I wouldn't put it past him. He's got the quirky steals. The Kog'Maw could happen as well.
It's going to be rough. Blinded. Okay.
Oh! Just missed.
Half credit for trying.
Or you could do the Bloodwater Howling Gale Baron steal. All of the steals. All the memories.
But the crab, the real prize here. Oh, actually, they want Contractz.
Apparently, it is the crab they're going to fight over, not the dragon. Explosive cast there. GoldenGlue does have the wall, but the team is going to be here. Contractz is going to use as much damage as he can to try and get himself or the team an advantage in this situation. But no go. Too little, too late.
Nice focus there from Reignover and GoldenGlue. Not distracted by the little scuttler.
No.
They take down Contractz. They keep up the chase. And, you know, he's not able to buy enough time for his EQ to come back up. ReignOver, though, overstaying a little bit in the jungle.
Ooh, the wall pass. He's used everything he can to get away, and now he's going away. Jensen's going to get that first kill of the game with all the assists he's had. Teleports in with the gate and the cards. Not wild enough as GoldenGlue cleanses himself to safety once again. Fast on those fingers.
With that roam from the bottom lane, Team Liquid are able to take down this turret, but Cloud9... Looks like Impact actually wants to solo this Rift Trail. He can do it because, you know, the eye will open up for a top laner just like it does for a jungle. That's where, you know, most of the true damage comes from.
Can you cast the pillar behind him to hit him? I mean, come on, Kobe.
You can do whatever you want. Trundle, with his move speed, if you just put down the Frozen Tundra, you can walk right behind him, smack the eyeball, very easy. And as you can see, make very quick work of Shelly.
Taken so much control to that top lane now. We'll see this play once again. ReignOver just about got away.
Yep, Smoothie though, he's like, you're not getting out of this one, buddy. Ooh. He flashes. They get the jungler kill in answer to Contractz to avenge his death. Meanwhile, GoldenGlue, he only had to burn his cleanse and that was exchanged for the Twisted Fate ultimate. So not too bad of a little chase down there in mid. He lives just fine.
CS discrepancy is starting to climb a little bit in favor of C9. I should say CS advantages in favor of C9. 74-72 for Impact and Jensen. About 30-40 CS above their opponents. Ooh. And a little bit more love here. They can go right by Lourlo and just attack GoldenGlue, but they can't see ReignOver and Matt. That's what they were worried about. C9 holds off. Team Liquid making some good moves here. Just C9 playing too patient for them to work.
Yeah, Team Liquid hover to their side where they have all the vision. Smart thing to do there. You know, all their support here is coming from the bottom side. They've got plenty of wards in the blue quadrant. And they are able to avoid that engage while remaining around mid lane. They really want this turret. Pressing for it hard with five. Maokai could actually flank around and get an ultimate off too. Cloud9 need to be a bit careful.
They are going to hit. ReignOver Contractz going mano and mano. And it looks like he's going to get a little help from Piglet. He walks forward, puts himself in a pretty scary spot, but the rest of the team is backed off. Lourlo is being the front line for this. The reason Piglet can walk up and TL have just routed Cloud9.
Beautiful play here from Team Liquid. Like we said, Maokai flanks around. Taliyah wall sets this up, and they're able to get that ultimate from the side. Team Liquid, mid lane turret goes down. They even up the gold, and they're trying to push on further. Jensen's still split pushing on Twisted Fate out on the bottom side, and he does have his ultimate up, but it's not too threatening.
I thought that was going to happen completely different. Mid would be held, Rift Herald bot. They continue through bot, but TL just kind of turned that C9's play on their head. And see how they organize this.
A little bit more threatening, actually.
Yeah.
Jensen Lichbane was completed, so he finishes off that turret.
Gotta be careful.
And it's also a double Mountain Drake. Those really sneak up on you. If you're split pushing and you have a Lichbane Twisted Fate with double Mountain Drake, he actually just annihilated that turret. Anyways, here's a good look at the coordinated play from Team Liquid. Really nice dive there. They're able to get two members. Baron, though, the double Mountain Drake also helps with that one. Team Liquid need to keep eyes on that objective.
Is he close? Oh, just a few more minions. He won't take too much damage before he does hit, though. Cloud9 trying to activate the plays as they realize things are happening across the map. That's Matt down immediately. No more Ardent Sensor for Piglet, but he's still able to fire back with two for himself. Bot lane goes down. Rift Herald going down as well, but C9 and Team Liquid trying to make things happen on the map instantly as they come out of base.
Yeah, Piglet stands strong there, gets two kills in answer for the engagement, and just absolutely starting to melt people already. It's that Blade of the Rune King plus the Hurricane combo. It's strong for Kalista in the mid game we talked about. It's also extremely strong for Kog'Maw. He just pops the W, able to flash out of the Cataclysm to gain some distance, and then he sees Smoothie running with no ultimate on, and takes him out immediately. That red buff doing some work.
Another 48 attack damage on top of that for Matt Storm Shield, which he got off before he died.
Whew. Ardent Sensor as well, baby.
Yeah. That's the quick first item that Matt actually built up before even finishing his Sightstone item, making sure that Kog'Maw Piglet would be the carry of this game. Now he's going to focus on clearing mid. He's flanked on both sides by protection and wards. And we'll see Impact head back down towards the bottom lane here. Tiamat for himself just continues to push. Or Hydra, I should say.
Matt Kog'Maw W. One auto attack. Scares off both of the backline members. We're already getting a glimpse of, you know, the power of this combination from the backline. Can Team Liquid continue to move with it, though? They're down a little bit in gold. It's not too big of an issue right now. The biggest thing is going to be keeping control of these objectives, because Cloud9 do have very good split pushers. Already talked about the double mountain trick, but Trundle is going to beat up on Maokai so easily. Spirit Visions and a Ravenous Hydra. Yep. There's actually nothing that Lourlo can ever do in that one versus one. And if Twisted Fate is walking around, then he's even got a fear for his life. So Team Liquid, their real fight is with keeping vision and trying to fend off the split push.
Well, let's see if they can jockey for position here towards this Baron attempt. Teleport is not up for impact just yet. We still have to be careful. Both of these top laners can push each other out of those TP skills.
The Bramble Vest is a decent answer from Lourlo, you know, to try and mitigate some of the healing. But even that, Trundle with Spirit Visions and the extra that he gets from his passive anyway is a ridiculous amount. So even cut in half, you know, Frozen Domain and all that, gonna do its work.
Well, flash forward there from ReignOver. Thought he could get the pop and knock up onto Contractz, which would have given them a much stronger than 50-50 Baron.
Here's now, the thing, though. Brambleback only works if you attack the Maokai.
Uh-oh.
Now he's doing it.
Oh, just a little bit faster. Or got hit by the first one, rather, and gets out. You can see it actually went around him already.
Maokai can keep up this chase, and Impact already used his ultimate.
Oh, boy. This is where it becomes real tough. Throws down the pillar, and it looks like they're going to have to call Piglet down with all that vision. Impact says, I don't want that fight anymore.
But a third Mountain Drake is on the table, and Impact can easily solo that one just like he did the Rift Herald. If the rest of the team can keep Team Liquid away.
Gold evening up.
Ward here from Team Liquid actually should see him.
Sneaking on the top side. If they decide to go for this fight, nope. The backs come in. It looks like they're going to say, it's Baron, let this go. We can have a bigger fight for what comes at Baron.
Triple freaking Mountain Drake, Riv.
There can't be any more in this game.
There cannot be any more. The only more.
It's infernal.
The only more you could get would be an Elder Dragon buffing up the buffs that you get here, but they can actually. I'm wondering if Trundle could even solo Baron at this point with three Mountain Drakes. They can definitely easily two-man Baron with anybody, so. Oh, God, they're going to do it, and they can burn so fast. Blast going over. Team Liquid has to check this. Maokai does have teleport ready, but he's far away.
Oh, Rainover's there. It's well within range for Rainover to do something. He gets Storm Shield immediately. Does mean it's not Piglets, but not a huge deal until the fight happens. Popped out. Contractz doesn't get a Cataclysm back. Baron's left alone. It's Smoothie going down first. Contractz very low as well. Matt's going to stay alive if he gets himself out of the fight. Contractz actually falls. How are TL members still alive at this point as C9 starts to get to the backside? Smoothie, sliver of health here. Sneaky. Only about 500 as it creeps up. Golden Glue, the wall is just short. And it looks like TL stop C9 on this Baron, all dragons aside, or drakes, I should say. What a fight.
Oh my goodness, Lourlo, you know, heals up the full off the minion wave as well, and Team Liquid chased them off. I'm almost as surprised as you that only one member of Cloud9 died in that as they were trapped in Baron. It got down to 2,000 health too, so that's one of those panic situations where it's a close call, but if you continue to try and burn down that Baron, not only is there a chance to get stolen away, but you lose the fight afterwards. Yeah. So Cloud9, they make a call to scramble and try and get out of here. They focus Piglet as best they can, but Piglet, even staying inside the Cataclysm, just fights his way out, takes down Contractz. Everybody else on Cloud9 has to scramble. Flashes are blown, and they barely escape without more casualties. That was a very close call. Whew.
It's like Baron might still be up as well as we come out of this replay. Sneaky getting himself through the brush to safety, but TL will gain control of this area quite fast. They'll have the wards down, and C9's going to have to do a little recouping.
Yeah, props to Team Liquid for recognizing the situation. They've constantly, you know, come back to check the Baron over and over and chase Cloud9 off a couple of times. They're definitely cognizant of the triple mountains and the, you know, power that brings to burning down those objectives.
Ooh. Offer a little damage back for taking his ward. Sneaky stays very careful in this situation. Those bot lane summoners are down for Smoothie and Sneaky. That's a lot of protection for him. So we might see Smoothie with not big as big of an initiation in this next fight. The rest of the team, or I should say the rest of Liquid moving together here. They gained front control over Baron, and now they actually have back control on that red side of C9.
Lourlo, as long as he's got this turret here, and a brush for extra damage on his sapling, is not afraid because Impact doesn't want to attack him due to the bramble vest that he's got. Impact, once you get to the point where you ignore the Maokai though, and you just turret, that's where things start to get a little bit risky. Team Liquid, look at the four-man squad. They're chasing into the jungle right now, looking for an engage, and they got Smoothie's ultimate down as well.
Walk back up and hit it. He does need a minion, though.
It's pretty low there. A couple of chomps on it.
Yeah, that's the thing, too. He can bite it. Oh, man. Sneaky moving around by himself here, but not in a very scary position. Could just look to deter the rest of TL off of this engage. Lourlo might have to go back and even get some mana before he can teleport into a fight. And even those are down right now. So it looks like things are actually going to take their time for the moment. A little bit of breathing room for both teams before they can get that big fight back in with teleports up.
Yep, Impact finally got the bottom turret. He worked hard for it, and now the ultimate from Twisted Fate scares off Lourlo, but Jensen's not even in range to teleport down there. He's going for Piglet? That's risky.
Oh boy, Voidu's just missing there, especially on a non-ghosted TF. We do have him running that Ignite. So things could get scary. We see how Piglet's not afraid to take those fights, though, with the pressure his team just set up. That area is clear for them.
Remember, the QSS is a 90-second cooldown, so that is a little bit of breathing room for Cloud9 to work around. Jensen didn't get to go back to base, though, so he's still only half health.
Whoa, Sneaky got out. He charged that jump before he got hit by the cast. Smoothie goes in. Remember, the ult was just used. They're forced into this fight. TL pressuring perfectly.
Good job for Team Liquid. They get the one kill onto the support. Now they're burning down the Baron. Actually, look at Impact. He's going on the inhibitor turret.
Oh, boy.
And Contractz is just going to try and steal it.
Yeah, they're not even halfway through this Baron. He's going to get onto the inhib, take the inhib as well. Mid lane's getting pushed. That's going to be three turrets if they can get the Tristana to the next one. Three Mountain Drakes here for what is happening for the Baron. Will it be enough for Liquid? Have they gone too far?
Well, as you said, triple Mountain Drakes means that in payment for Baron, you're going to have to give up two turrets plus an inhibitor. They get back in time to deal with all the minions, and they did kill off Contractz, but Cloud9, not too sad about that trade.
Nope.
Yeah, they'd rather not, you know, have Jensen gotten chunked out and Smoothie go down, but they don't feel too bad about the trade. Let's see what Team Liquid can actually do with this Baron buff, though, because when that Kog'Maw comes to town,
mm-hmm,
and Janna's buffing him up with the Ardent Sensor, definitely have to pay him some respects.
Got a second cleanse on that Mikhail's now. Get himself out of a scary situation with a bit of heal. So it is all about the Piglet and what he could do this game. Who can stay in front of him? ReignOver has been trying to get the initiations in. It seems like they are doing the Snap Judgment together. Snap Judgment kind of sounds bad, but they're all there. ReignOver with the flash hit on Contractz last time, the quick hits to get Smoothie's ultimate out. They're just looking to absorb whatever they can when they can. It's working pretty good.
Yeah, Team Liquid will be able to gain their Infernal Drink here. Baron gives them the extra power, and you can actually go buff up with Baron the bottom lane. So even though your inhibitor was taken on the bottom side, they can push that one all the way up to secondary turret, and they should still be able to get some gold out of this Baron buff, you know, by continually pressuring those two lanes, even with super minions heading down. Impact for Cloud9 is trying to answer on the top side, though, getting that one pushing, and he's level 16 now. So Lourlo's going back, but it might get to the point where Impact also ignores him on inhibitor turret and starts taking that one home. Teleport comes in from Jensen as well. He gets the stun down.
Lockdown, lockdown. Flash from Lourlo. Next card coming up. It's the gold. Ooh, almost got dashed out of the Twisted Advance there, but finds him on the other end as usual. And it looks like there's going to be the push. A teleport coming in.
Great call there from Cloud9. Now they do need to get out of it, though. ReignOver uses the cast on the chase.
No TP for this time. Impact going to be going down to GoldenGlue and Squad. Him and ReignOver making a pretty good Bash Brothers. And Piglet getting a bit more kite potential and kill potential on that Kog'Maw with the red.
All right, he's got a fresh red here, and they still have some time left on the Baron buff. It is 4v4. Lourlo comes up 20 seconds before Impact does, and he has teleport, so Team Liquid should not be wasting this time. And Piglet's actually making this call to go get a turret for himself. They will get that gold out of the Baron buff. But will they pay for it? Smoothie on a possible flank? That's super risky if there's no sneaky there. He's got to be careful because GoldenGlue is going to find him.
I feel like Piglet feels like he has the front because he can void ooze. He just says make sure that exit is clear. They were behind him until now. He needs a front line. They're inside the base. What a rotation as they slowly make their way up mid here, putting the pieces and one foot after the other. And they're pushing C9 around at this point.
Yeah, that Baron has really paid off for Team Liquid. Uh-oh.
Do we speak too soon? The Cataclysm keeps him in from the Buster shot, where the damage can still continue on the Contractz. ReignOver to finish that off, and TL's going for the base.
Yeah, they
Oh!
I was going to say, if he killed Contractz, they might actually be able to end the game. They're still going to try and end the game here. Baron buff does time out, so it's going to be a little bit more difficult. There goes Smoothie!
Across the map for both teams, Impact fighting on the top side to win, but it's Piglet on the bottom side coming out with results and the rest of the squad from Team Liquid here. It's a double kill for GoldenGlue, and at 12-6, Team Liquid has the base waiting for minions. It's the only thing they don't have at this point.
And Contractz is still on the run here. ReignOver's been on this ride for a long time and is getting dizzy. Meanwhile, the rest of the team still focused here. Nexus is their target.
And over the wall, he's working up quite a tab there with Contractz. They're gonna be going for the Nexus. It's gonna be hits in from Piglet. He's gonna get the kill on the Impact, though. He wants to pat that KDA. And it's a 4-0-7 Piglet, protected by Team Liquid. As the real fight is out by Baron, the Nexus goes down. Game one, Team Liquid over C9.
Piglet on the Kog'Maw.
No wonder he's so happy today. Keeps that flow and ends the game with
visualize the win.
$3,000 in his pocket that he didn't even need to spend. Hopefully they can take those and let it burn holes through their pocket in the next game. These are the wins that Team Liquid needs to find here with the ever-evolving and rotating roster towards the end of the split. They're locking things down.
Yeah, I mean, that one really came together for them in the end.
Yeah.
This focus on the Baron. They were facing a triple Mountain Drake with very strong split pushers on the enemy
staring
team.
Down the barrel.
So you have to make the call. And the point there when you're in that scenario is whatever you're doing, you have to be very decisive with it because every second means Impact's going to take another objective, you know?
Yeah.
Takes down that inhibitor turret, takes down the inhibitor. But they use that Baron buff to get so much more back for themselves. Definitely some good focus there from Team Liquid. And some surprising upset here. They take game one off Cloud9. Pretty big stuff.
So good. We're actually going to take a look at that last replay in a few minutes. Overall, or a few seconds, as we don't have a few minutes. Overall, looking at how that played out, it was just TL continuously pushing, wanting that Baron very, very bad, and pretty much saying, yeah, turrets are for now. This Baron is for the next few minutes. We're going to use that. That's pretty much what they went in, right?
That's definitely
looking
the case.
At the team comp, they wondered, Maokai jungler top, they're going to flex to start things off. They took the Taliyah early for GoldenGlue's comfort, and they figured they would get the Kog'Maw in the end if they needed to protect, and they did a pretty good job of protecting Piglet.
Yeah, I like it when we have games like this, because it's very clear, right, from champion to like, okay, 5-on-5 team, split push team. And Cloud9, the split push team getting a bunch of Mountain Drakes is great for them, right? That's one of the biggest, you know, assets that they can have. So it started out quite well for Cloud9, actually. And they were using the pressure decently, but Team Liquid were able to make the crucial Baron, crucial team fight there as well. I think that we have the replay for us.
Yeah, almost have it up. Looking also from the other side, Impact back in for C9 on that top, crushing on this Trundle. But you can't even like say it wasn't him. Here's the replay as we get back in. We'll get back to talking about Impact on the top, but TL were able to stay for the long haul, even after being down so much.
Yeah, and this is actually just the cleanup. So this is the four-man squad. Well, we are watching the Contractz versus ReignOver ring around the rosy circle thing. Impact right there was going down the mid lane to go for those minions.
Looked fun.
Just got a little taste there. That's just if you only came in now and get to see the beginning of the game.
Yeah.
Honestly though, it really did come down to the team play and came down to Piglet. They protect Piglet. They have the Janna. You know, they've built this 5-on-5 composition. Front line in front. Janna in the back protecting the Kog'Maw, and Cloud9 not able to kill off that Kog'Maw. That's a crucial thing.
And those are a few of the new ones we saw coming in. Matt bringing out that Janna. The TF going over to Jensen this time. A little more map control in his presence. Obviously puts the Taliyah in his hand, so the roaming isn't anything that's new to him. But it definitely didn't come out in the end game. It seemed like with all that map pressure, we see Cloud9 win a game. But somehow TL, with coming from behind, were able to restructure themselves. Something we don't usually see. Being able to end that Nexus. They get stuck right in front of that base gate.
Yeah, definitely rough times there. And, you know, happy for Team Liquid, because they have had it very rough, right?
Yep.
They've been switching through all these players, and they're getting a lot of criticism. But, you know, GoldenGlue gets a win for himself. ReignOver's back in. He's playing a tank. He's on Gragas. He definitely looked good there doing it, and they're able to make those crucial plays. Plus, he got to chase around Contractz at the end, delay his base, and get that victory for the team. So,
yeah.
Moving on to game number two here, Cloud9, they're one of the teams that are tied in kind of the little bottom pocket of the playoff teams.
Right.
They're pretty much in there as far as the playoffs, but they desperately need these wins for the second half of the split. For their seeding in playoffs, which is very
absolutely
important.
I mean, you have to think a few other teams are going to be able to put themselves over Team Liquid if they play it, who are above the lift. If TSM were to play this game, you expect to go a different way. So like you said, C9 kind of need these wins right now, make them happen. We'll see if C9 can even up the score.